Your boss just assigned you to lead a project, and the expectations are that the quality is high, it's done in half the time, and it comes in under budget. Should you just start working on your resume now, or might there be a lesson for everyone in this assignment? Maybe send them this video to inform future decisions, because I'm going to reveal to you what I think is one of the immutable laws of the universe. This is the E equals MC squared of project management, or coding, or almost anything you try to do. It's this. Good, fast, cheap. Pick any two. Don't believe me? Think you can have all three? I'm going to explain to you why you only get two and you can only pick those two. So let's take an example of a coding project, large project, and now we've got to try to optimize on all of these. We're going to look at three different parameters: headcount, or the number of people that we throw at the project. There's the amount of time we give them to work on the project, and then there's the speed that where they are expected to operate. In other words, how fast do they have to produce this code? So let's take a look what happens. In the first example, let's say I increase the headcount. I put more people on the project. Well, it could be good now, because now we have more people working on it. We can do more quality control. They can do more code reviews and things like that. Maybe even more design and make a better project out of the whole thing. It's going to be faster with more people on it, potentially, because now, as they say, many hands make for light work. But is it going to be cheap? No, because guess what? These people want to be paid. And the more we put on that, the more expensive the project gets. And by the way, there is a point of diminishing returns at throwing more people at a project. Former IBMer Fred Brooks wrote a book many years ago called The Mythical Man Month, where he talked about how, in one example, we know that it takes, typically, a woman 9 months to have a baby. Well, that doesn't mean you can have nine women have a baby in 1 month. So it doesn't always work out as simply as the math would indicate. Spreadsheets are one thing, the real world is another. So there's a point where throwing more people at a project actually doesn't make it better. It actually could slow it down. If, for instance, we had 1,000 people writing one line of code, that's going to take a lot longer than one person writing that and actually getting it to work. So let's take a look at another example. Now we're going to look at the amount of time we give them. So if we give them on this project more time, well, then potentially more time, better quality. They can look at, again, the things that they're doing and make sure it works well. More time, well, might be cheaper, because we're not having to work as fast. We didn't have to throw the number of people at the project. We could do it with fewer people because we have the luxury of time. However, what we don't get is fast, because in fact, that's the exact opposite of more time. So we got to optimize on two out of those three in that case. Then finally, let's take a look at speed. Let's say we increase the speed of the project and we say, you guys have to work faster. You've got to produce more lines of code than you've ever done before in a very short period of time. Well, what are we going to get in this case? Well, it's going to be fast. And that's what the objective was in that case. And if we're going really fast, we can slop right through this stuff and it's going to be cheap. But you know what it's not going to be? Good. Because in fact, we just ran roughshod over all the process. And now we end up with something that is fast and cheap, but not so good. So there you go. You've got three things you can optimize on: good, fast, cheap. But you can only pick two. And that's why I say this is one of the immutable laws of the universe. And learn these lessons, pass them along to your manager, have your manager learn these lessons, and you'll be a lot happier with the projects you produce. If you think there's an exception to this rule, and you aren't afraid of ripping a hole in the space-time continuum by discussing it, after all, I said this is an immutable law of the universe, write it in the comments section below. I'll be watching.